What if I told you the theory of everything, the holy grail that modern physicists are still chasing, was actually discovered 2,500 years ago? And what if I told you that while we are spending billions building particle colliders to find the smallest unit of reality, the exact lifespan of that particle was written down right here before we even invented the light bulb? Hi, I'm Cap. I'm a requirement engineer, a background in physics and computer science. I spent the last 10 years of my life translating and comparing a specific set of ancient texts with modern quantum physics. And what I found, honestly, it scared me. Because this isn't a modern science or religion or philosophy. It's a technical manual of how things work in nature. It describes the source code of the universe, mind and matter, with the precision that makes our modern instruments look like toys. In this series, I'm going to decode this manual for you. But first, you need to know who wrote it and why he had to hack reality to find it. The year is 500 BC. The world is waking up. In Greece, Pythagoras is obsessing over triangles. In China, Confucius is talking about order. But in the foothills of the Himalayas, a prince named Siddhartha is conducting a very different experiment. This guy had everything: wealth, power, luxury, but he realized a bug in the human system. Satisfaction is impossible. No matter how much we have, we suffer. We need more and more. We get sick, we get old, we die. He wanted to find the code that stops the suffering. So he did what any radical scientist would do. He gave up luxury lifestyle of the palace and quit his job as a prince and went into a great masters, teachers, and finally to his own lab in forest for discovery. After he mastered all teachers' techniques, realized they don't have the answer, then for 6 years he pushed the human body to its absolute limit. Following beliefs those days, he tried starvation until his stomach stuck to his spine. He tried holding his breath until he passed out, just to see if the answer was hidden in the biology. He even slept in cemeteries with rotting bones to understand death that everyone tries to avoid. The result? Nothing. He realized that the hardware, the body, wasn't the problem. The problem was with something else. So on a full moon night, he sat down under an asatoe tree, biological name is Ficus religiosa, and turned his laboratory inward. He deployed a super consciousness, a level of mental focus called samadhi, to observe reality at a frequency that normal humans can't see. And then he saw it. He saw the builder of the house, the builder of you. He realized that you are not a solid person. You are a stream of energy, transforming causes into effects over and over again. He discovered that energy cannot be destroyed, only transformed. A modern law of physics he found 2,500 years before we did. And that night, he cracked the code. He became the Buddha, which literally means the one who knows, or the one with ultimate intelligence. But he didn't just say peace and love. He said, question yourself, be experimental, discover yourself. He spent the next few weeks digesting the exact mechanism of how this works. He categorized every single component of the mind and the physical matter around you. He introduced a new unbreakable science system called the Abhidhamma. I could not find better words to interpret the real meaning of this. Usual science can be changed, but this science does not change. It is the ultimate reality of everything. It is the law of nature of everything, not only just matter, but also mind. When I first learned about this, it scared me and gave me goosebumps. This isn't a religious text. It's a grand unified theory. Most people ignore it because it's incredibly complex. It lists 82 fundamental elements of reality. It breaks down the mind, chitta, 52 mental factors called chetasika, 28 forms of matter, rupa, the exit called nirvana. This technical manual makes a bold claim. It may shock you as well, but hold on. The world you see, tables, chairs, even your own face, is a lie. It's only a conventional reality. Underneath that is the ultimate reality. Modern science is just barely scratching the surface of this. We are building quantum computers to find flocked state of matter. But this manual described the lifespan of those states 25 centuries ago. So here's the plan. I'm going to translate this manual for you. We are going to look at the software, the mind, and the hardware, the matters in the universe. But I have to warn you, once you see the math, things start looking crystal clear. You will never look at the world or yourself the same way again. In the next episode, I am going to prove to you that you don't exist. I'm going to show you the mechanism that proves you are actually 1 trillion different people every single second. If you want to unlock your reality, hit subscribe and stay tuned to watch episode 2. Trust me, you are not ready for the speed of your own mind. See you there.